Today we'll do the subject science of grade 6 and our chapter number 9 is motion and types of motion. What is the meaning of motion? Motion means movement, changes in the place of an object. So let us see the first point, that is, what is displacement? Displacement means change in the place of an object is called displacement. For example, I have an eraser in my right hand. Now, I am going to change this eraser place from right to the left. So, this change in the place of an object is known as displacement. The next one is, what is motion? These changes in an object is called motion. The movement of an object is called motion. So let us see the other things, that is types of motion. Two types. The first one is linear motion and the second one is non-linear motion. In linear motion, we have two types, that is uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. And in non-linear motion, we have four types, that is oscillatory motion, circular motion, random motion and periodic motion. So let us discuss about types of motion, that is linear motion. In linear motion, the object goes or change in straight line. For example, a train or a moving vehicle on the road. Next is, in linear motion we have uniform linear motion, that is when a distance traversed by an object along a straight line in unit time is the same. In uniform linear motion, the object time is unit and it always same. For example, marching parade of a soldier. Next is non-uniform linear motion. In non-uniform linear motion, the distance traversed by an object along a straight line in unit time keeps on changing. Here the unit time is same, but here non-uniform linear motion, the unit time will change. For example, a girl coming down from a slide. So these are the examples and definitions of linear motion. Now let us discuss about non-linear motion. Non-linear motion does not move in a straight line. See, linear motion always move in a straight line, but non-linear motion, it does not move in a straight line. So let us see the first point, that is entry motion. The motion of an object swinging back and forth, that is oscillating. In oscillatory motion, the object comes in forward, then again came in the same place, that is backward. It is known as oscillatory motion. For example, movement of a pendulum of a clock. Then the next example is vibrating drum and tabla. Pedal of a swing machine, etc. are the example of oscillatory motion. Next is circular motion, means the object turns in circular, in circle or in round motion. That is the motion of an object along a circular path. It always goes in circular manner. For example, a clock, the hand or the minute hand of a clock. Next is table fan, ceiling fan. And the most important example, that we are going to a fair and in that fair we can see a giant wheel. It also rotates in circular motion and also a merry-go-round. Now the third one, that is random motion. What is random motion? Random motion means changes its direction and speed continuously. It never be in a straight line. It never be in a circular motion. It never be in a oscillatory motion. It randomly changes the speed or time continuously. For example, crawling baby, flying birds and butterflies, wandering animals, swimming fish. These are the example of random motion. The last one is periodic motion. In periodic motion, motion, the motion of a moving object in which it passes through a certain point again and again after a fixed period of time. In periodic motion, the distance or the displacement of an object is as a fixed period of time. For example, movement of a minute hand in a clock, it always have a fixed time. And oscillatory motion and circular motion are also the type of periodic motion. Next is speed. What is meant by speed? When we have to calculate or measure the distance of a thing, we have to use speed. The distance traversed by an object in unit time means the distance we have to measure of a particular time, that is in unit we have to use. Next, the ratio of distance and the time required to cover the distance. If we have to find or understand the speed, so we have to calculate the ratio of the distance of that particular time required to cover the distance. The formula of speed is equal to distance traversed upon time required for traversing the distance. This is the formula, and by this formula you can easily calculate the speed. Next is, the unit of speed is in kilometer, hour or meter per second. So today we have discussed about motion and types of motion. We have different types of motion, and that different type of motion have their particular examples also.